of translation, we would talk separately about all the cells. But a very important difference between the two is in eukaryotic cell, we can see that when DNA is used to make RNA after the transcription, it's not done yet. The RNA is not the final RNA product. The RNA will be processed. So this process, we call it transcriptional modification. And here's RNA processing labeled here. And generally, it's some kind of modification on RNA. So here's an extra step in eukaryotic cells. And later, we'll talk about more details of this part. And then RNA is used. And also here, we can see that in eukaryotic cells, transcription happens in the nucleus. And then translation happens in the cytoplasm. And in prokaryotic cells, all the steps happen in the cytoplasm. And now here is a more detailed view of transcription and translation. If we focus inside the nucleus on a section of the chromosome, what we have here on the top is a small section of a chromosome, and there are some genes on the chromosome. And then the blue sequence we have here is one small section from the little box here. So that is one small section of gene 1. And we can see the nitrogenous base sequence here. And in transcription, later we'll talk about more details of transcription. In transcription, RNA will be made based on DNA information, and the RNA made has a complementary sequence to the sequence of the DNA template. So this is the template, and this is the RNA made. And here if we compare the blue sequence and the red sequence, you can see that they are complementary to each other. Except for in RNA, there is no T. U is U to replace T. So in DNA, when there is A on RNA, there is U. And when there is C in DNA, there is G on RNA. So the two sequences are complementary to each other. When the DNA information is transcribed, RNA sequence is complementary to the DNA template. And then there is a modification which is not shown here. After RNA is made in eukaryotic cells, there is a modification. And after that, there is translation. In translation procedure, the RNA information will be used to make proteins, and here, the codons will be used. And the codons, we will take a look at the codon dictionary later, if in your book. If we look at the codons, we can see that every three digits of the nitrogenous bases on the RNA form a codon. We call it codon because it provides some coded information for protein synthesis. And every codon is related to an amino acid. And in your book, later we'll take a look at the codon dictionary. From the codon dictionary, we'll see how the nitrogenous bases codons are related to the amino acid. So here, what we have here, all the three letter symbols represent amino acid. This is the amino acid tryptophan. And this is another amino acid. So all of these are amino acids. Each codon is related to an amino acid. And in protein synthesis, amino acids will be added to the product one after one because a protein is a polymer of amino acids. And then it is the codon.